unforgiving North Atlantic. For millennia, men have sought fortunes here. More than 10,000 never returned, including the six fishermen lost in the perfect storm. Still, every fall, a handful of brave crews risk everything in search of big fish.
Don't let it get away!
Got him.
Here's a $1,000 bill with fins.
And a bigger payday.
Money, money, money!
Off.
It's an epic gamble where one mistake...
That one's still fighting.
...can get you killed. It's 6 weeks into an outstanding fall season.
Yeah.
That's what I'm coming to see right there.
But since a vicious storm nearly took out the Eagle Eye 2,
this truly sucks.
The fleet is on high alert.
This is a real deal. You make the wrong mistakes, you're gonna pay for it.
100 miles off the coast of New Jersey is the Francis Ann.
Time to go, men.
And Captain Slick Clem is anxious.
I hope we catch something today. Just want to get situated. I hate having to drive around and not find a home.
Slick and his crew of young guns are coming off an epic first trip.
Best trip I've ever been out on.
24-6-27, Bubba. Come on.
3 days of work. $1,000 a day, can't complain.
But Slick's young crew did a little too much partying after the last trip.
We got screwed out of 45 minutes of sleep.
Danny decided it was time to wake up, so he turned the light on, even though we had 45 more minutes of sleep.
Now restocked with $30,000 of fuel and provisions, the Francis Ann is back in the hole. And the only way to dig out is to put some fish on the boat.
Any reason why you got your sunglasses on and still dark out?
And it looks like the crew left their A-game on shore.
Come on, ladies, let's go. We've been off for 3 days.
And no one feels the pressure more than 21-year-old deckhand Lemmy Eastburn.
It's 3 foot of water down there, idiot. You're a idiot.
Take this.
6 hooks and nobody's around. Swordfish. Somebody clear that, man. All right, listen. Tui has got to do something. One has got to do something. We're drifting over it. It's coming out the other side.
Slick's crew missed unhooking an empty leader, which is now tangled around the fish and mainline.
Somebody take this! Somebody take this! What the man? Pull your heads out of your 3 days off. Let's go. Why is everybody standing behind me when there's the fish is up forward?
Yeah.
Woo, come on.
Yeah.
I'm assembling my tally board. Whether I'm gonna put anything else on it, that's a different story.
Big eye, come on!
Tuned up here.
Come on, what a big eye.
Thank you.
Come on.
Come on.
It it's a money fish.
Big Eye tuna can fetch three times more per pound than swordfish. They're the gold standard of longline fishing.
That looks like we're right on. We're catching big eyes. That's what we wanted.
Swordfish!
Yeah!
Woo! Come on.
But swordfish are still the backbone of a good trip.
Yeah!
Woo!
Coming at you, Danny. Nice swordfish.
Yeah, woo! Woo!
Pick, 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 pick. Slow pick, nice puff. We'll take it. Nice sword, nice sword!
Woo!
Woo! That's what I'm talking about.
Woo!
Come on.
Here we go.
Nice job.
Right.
Hell's yeah.
That was awesome. Woo!
Yeah,
come on, baby. Free gap and swordfish. Good job, Lem. Give me some pounds.
Woo!
Come on, man. A little relieved, not out of the woods. A little relieved.
The first day back has erased a quarter of the Francis Ann's debt. A few more days like this, and Slick and his crew will be out of the hole and into the money.
1,900 pounds. We had almost 2,000 pounds today. 1,900. Tomorrow's another day.
Miles to the northeast, in the small fishing village of Bay Bulls, Newfoundland, are the Bjorn 2 and the Eagle Eye 2.
Ready?
Big fish coming up, up easy.
2 days ago, Eagle Eye 2 Captain Scotty Drabinowitz and his veteran crew ran in early to catch a high market price.
Just got the news, the price just went up $1.50 a pound. We got it, we're going.
But hurricane force winds in the harbor nearly smashed the boat and crew on the jagged Newfoundland coast.
We had a lot of trouble getting in, but we couldn't get to the dock. The weather was
glad to be at this point. I knew we'd get here someday. I was hoping yesterday, but that just wasn't the day. Too damn rough.
Now it's time for the Eagle Eye 2 to cash in on their white-knuckle trip to the dock.
It's a nice fish.
All right, here we go. Don't get under that fish now. Always love to see big fish come out of the hole.
Holy smoke.
Swordfish are a Grand Banks fisherman's bread and butter.
Pretty fish there. Chubby, big, thick belly walls. Thick belly walls go with a good price.
Handsome-looking specimen.
But a bluefin tuna is a five-star meal.
Oh my God, I've never seen a fish that big here.
Anything that weighs 600 pounds helps out the trip.
Ready? Yep.
A tuna's quality is determined on the dock by a tuna broker.
Color, you want a nice cherry red. It turns to brown as it ages or it heats up and burns. So the more cherry, the better. And the more fat content, the better.
Oh, oh!
600 and something, I'd say around $6-7 a pound, 4,000 off the top of my head, 4,000 or 5,000 maybe.
Once their quality is established, these prize jewels are packed in their own special case and shipped to market. Tomorrow, there'll be sushi in a fine Manhattan restaurant.
Oh, hold on, hold on. Ready? That fish definitely over 500.
583. That's a big fish.
583. Come on. That's a beauty right there.
This monster sword might pay Scotty twice. He has a wager with Linda over who catches the biggest fish.
We ain't got the big ones out yet.
Oh, quiet, you.
That's a pig right there, man.
Yep, that's a big fella. That's a big
I think I'm on $100. That's what I think. This is getting very expensive. Do you take Canadian?
Take Sucre, take rubles, take it all.
You take plastic?
Take plastic. We elicit all forms of payment.
Right? I really thought I had it made this trip. You know, we had some really nice fish, but our biggest one was $4.92, and I thought, yes, $100 in my pocket. Friggin' Scotty. He's a tough guy to beat.
Just won the bet, happy about that, but what we got down here is big money.
45,000, we're happy about that, can't complain, we're thrilled.
At an average of $3 a pound, the Eagle Eye 2 will gross over $120,000 on this trip alone.
I'm happy. I'm real happy.
Coming up.
How about a bet, you and me?
Gambling for dinner on the Francis Ann.
If you catch the biggest fish of the day, I'll cook dinner. If I catch a sword bigger than yours, you have to cook dinner.
And gambling with their lives on the Big Eye.
And overboard! And overboard!
A 100 miles off the coast of New Jersey is the Francis Ann.
But we're not catching much.
After pulling up over 2,000 pounds yesterday,
come on, baby, free gapping swordfish.
Today, Slick is coming up empty.
Surprised, thought we were doing a little better today, but still have 3 sections to go. Anything's possible.
To change his luck, Slick gives Lemmy a rare chance to run the haul back.
Want to catch Slick some fish? Keep in a good mood.
Come on, fish!
Empty hub.
Got something.
He's got something.
Feels like there's something on here coming up. I'm not sure, though. Feeling a little bit of weight. I'm still new. It's probably a shark.
Can grow up to 14 feet and weigh up to 1,400 pounds. Any fish over 100 pounds is called a marker. 200 pounds is a double marker, and so on.
Lemmy with the mark.
It's the first like big fish I've ever caught besides like a blue dog. Pretty proud of him.
Nice marker, Bubba. How about a bet, you and me? If you catch the biggest fish of the day, I'll cook dinner. If I catch a sword bigger than yours, you have to cook dinner.
All right, I'll take you, man.
Roger, roger. Thank you. Swordfish!
Is this your entry right here in the bet?
Slick's first sword comes up short.
My fish is bigger than Slick's.
Get out of here with that thing.
Hey, mine's bigger.
Oh, small sod. Just released it. Good release, Dan. We'll catch him next year. He'll be a 60-pounder.
With only a few hooks to go, time is running out for the captain.
Live swordfish. Look at that leaf lit up. Look how purple he is. Woo!
I definitely don't think that's fair, man. No.
Got you nervous, though.
That one doesn't beat Lemmy's. So it goes on.
Starting to sweat the bet, Lem.
Small sword, 50-pounder, 40-pounder, something like that. Not as big as mine. Rat! Rat sword!
As the last hook comes on board, Slick's looking like a loser.
I won the bet. That's a first. That's the first time I have one up. And when we get to the dock, that's probably the first thing I'm gonna say to our boss, Rick, is, yo, one day I caught a sword bigger than Slick. I got one up on him.
Tonight, the captain cooks.
Onion rings, corn, and ribs.
Another epic meal on the Francis Ann.
But with a good meal,
corn,
everyone wins.
I was definitely 30 minutes or less that meal.
Rachel Ray Lavelle.
A 100 miles north in the fishing town of New Bedford, Massachusetts, the tiny Big Eye is back at the dock for repairs.
How you doing this morning?
I come in because I had some problems with my heat pump. That means that there's no air in the boat, no central air or heat. It makes it where we can't live. I don't want to go fishing unless the boat's at 100%.
The repair will take 3 hours. Chomps takes the time that he's stuck waiting to find a replacement for Deckhand Mullet.
I'm gonna make a few calls, get a crew member, and if I can, I'll go shorthand.
It's a big fishing village here, basically, so hopefully we'll be able to find a man.
New Bedford's a really hard place to find anybody that's not got problems or issues.
I need somebody to go. Guy just left me.
There is no way I can even get a crew member up here.
Being a man down has forced Greenhorn Don to step up.
Me and Woody's gonna really take the heat on it if we don't find another man. I'm gonna have to be pulling hooks in and putting dobs away and, you know, pulling poly balls and all that stuff. So Chris can really haul gear and he can stack you up quick.
Forced in after only one day of fishing.
Oh, all right, come on up for these two.
The Big Eye's offload will be small.
This is it. Back there, 1,000 pounds, a little more maybe. Ain't much.
The fish is offloaded, the boat is repaired, but Chomps is still a man down.
Been losing time, one problem after the next, so right now I just gotta go fishing.
This is Captain's call. If he says we're going three-handed, we're going three-handed. So.
I have no choice. It's the way Chompers does it, I guess. I got to go suck it up and deal with it.
600 miles to the north in Bay Bulls, Newfoundland, the Eagle Eye 2 and the Bjorn 2 are still tied to the dock.
Water.
Ready to go?
Hello, Skipper. When are you casting?
Right now. Yep, we're out of here.
Throw your lines.
Yeah, we're out of here.
I'll call you on 10. We'll be right behind you.
With storms brewing in the North Atlantic, Scotty knows it's just a matter of time before the Grand Bank season comes to a close.
Good thing.
See you, Patrick. Good luck.
I'm just pulling off the dock here now. Bound for sea.
Linda's itching to join Scotty, but she's been stuck on the dock waiting for more gear.
I keep looking at the dock like I'm gonna see a truck come and drive myself nuts. Man, I hate to see them getting out before us. We've been here for so long.
Within hours, the Eagle Eye 2 is in the open ocean. Scotty plots his course to the fishing grounds.
Just checking out my orb system here. Seeing where we're going to be headed to.
But on the computer screen, all he sees is a big red roadblock.
Yeah, red is waves, and there's plenty of it. They're showing about 11 meter seas in that storm.
Brian and Daryl are just going to get suited up, make a double check on the deck here. Just make sure everything's secure or tied down or taken off the deck.
Yeah, it's better to come out now than have to come out again when the weather's twice as bad as this. A lot safer this way. That way we don't end up getting washed overboard or injured any kind of way.
Scotty can do now is face this massive storm head on and hope to survive it.
I mean, nice weather's all over and done with. Fantasy's done. Now reality sets in.
Bay Bulls, Newfoundland. After waiting over a week for their gear, the Bjorn 2 is finally heading out for their second trip.
Ready, Timmy?
With more frequent storms and colder water rushing down from the north, Captain Linda Greenlaw's Grand Banks season is rapidly coming to a close.
All aboard is going aboard.
Got all the gear made up. I had plenty of time on the dock to do that. Just getting everything tied back down and getting everything ready. You never know what kind of weather we're going to be running into.
I have no idea what we have in store, what's ahead of us here. We're going to go out, we're going to look for some fish, we're going to make some sets. Hopefully we'll land on something worth working on.
We just have to get back on them.
One 100 miles off the New Jersey coast is the 72-foot Francis Ann.
Catching nothing. Just hope for a couple good fish, but maybe on the other end, still got a ways to go.
Captain Slick's depending on the 30 miles of line the crew set out last night. Each of the 1,000 baited hooks is a chance to put the boat back in the black.
50 hooks.
But so far, today's fishing has been thin.
We're catching nothing. Except the little runny nose.
Nah, we haven't really been catching much. A yellowfin, small yellowfin, small big eye, and a large pup swordfish. Slow day so far.
Despite the small haul, the young guns have managed to cover the trip's expenses. Anything they catch from now on will be money in their pockets.
This hook is bending my string. There you go. This hook is definitely not empty.
There you go.
You see his mouth?
Woo-hoo! Probably a $200 fish right there. 100 pound mako, $200. You don't get much for him, but it's something.
Swordfish! Come on!
Yeah! Woo. Nice swordfish.
Albacore tuna.
Six fish. Couple sharks. Nothing else to it.
And hopefully we can go uphill from there. You know, see what happens tonight.
But just as the crew starts making money, Slick gets a call on the satellite phone telling him to bring the boat in.
Roger. All right.
It's gonna be crappy weather for 4 days. We have the option to run towards the dock, and that's what we're gonna do.
Now he's gotta break the bad news to his crew.
Weather's gonna be Thursday. Rick wants us to come in, so that's what's going on. You guys probably know we're not going to make any money. Probably got enough fish to cover expenses, so we didn't go forward, we didn't go back. So we're just going to have to take it as it's dealt.
Off the coast of New Bedford, the little 58-foot Big Eye struggles against the Atlantic's fury.
And once more again, I put the boat into the hole, further into the hole.
Chops is trying to salvage a bad week. Between mechanical breakdowns and crew members jumping ship, Chops can't catch a break.
That's the way it goes. That's what happens when you become a fisherman. get them sometimes, and then sometimes you don't.
Last night, he set out in the path of this massive 1,200-mile storm. Now, he's paying for it.
Not a nice day.
Into the day. The update is
catching nothing, getting ass kicked.
Swordfish!
Rope him up there.
Bring it on a boat.
But a nice marker brings a little hope.
Need help!
Getting in here.
Next up, a tuna.
Big eye!
It might be smaller than the marker, but it's big money once they get it to market. But Chomps' good luck doesn't last for long.
That one's not even spooling. Damn. I think the thing's wore out in it.
Hold up.
What the?
Is it moving or not? The thing's wore out in it.
The leveler that spools the main line has broken down, causing a snag on the drum.
Get the tools out, Woody.
Chomps' brother Woody has to reverse the drum and let the main line out until he finds the snag.
Still got to take some off of there. It's a good little pile on the drum.
It's all right. I think it's just jammed the up.
It's wore out, I can tell you that.
It might last today, but.
I'm going to start hauling again. It's going to see if it does it again. Let the line out.
This will all do it right here.
Woody manages to get the leveler tracking evenly.
Going back and forth to that one little spot for while like that. As long as it's still spooling, it'll be all right until we get done home.
But it's a temporary repair that could go at any time. Over the next 3 hours, the storm continues to intensify. And worse, it's chased the fish away. What they are catching are either too small or blue dog sharks. But then,
big eye!
There's cash on the line. This big eye has been turned into dinner for the sharks.
Oh, it's in the water. Big eye!
The big eye gets one last chance to salvage their day. Losing one of the few money fish of the day finally forces Chomps' hand. With barely enough in the hole to make a fish sandwich.
End of the gear.
Here
Chops turns tail and points his battered boat 1,000 miles south.
The weather's gonna be a lot nicer, a lot warmer. Looking for some nice swordfish and some nice tunas, and I will sniff them out.
Miles north, the Bjorn 2 is bobbing mercilessly in turbulent seas.
The weather's coming on. You know, we're expecting a storm, and I think this is just the beginning of it. We're going to get a lot of wind. The worst of it's going to be probably this evening.
The storm that chased Chomps south is now descending on legendary Captain Linda Greenlaw.
So it's really my responsibility to handle the boat the bad weather.
While Linda struggles to stay on course, down below, her crew does its best to just hang on.
Hold on. Wow.
Deckhand Dave Hiltz has had a bad attitude the entire season, and this isn't helping.
The only one I'm a little nervous about is Dave Hiltz because he's been so miserable all trip. His head hasn't been here, his heart has not been here.
Why do you constantly torment us with the prospect of catching fish?
And though he promised Linda he was committed to a second trip.
I'm in.
Yep, you're in.
I'm in.
All right. Sorry.
Bad weather has made it impossible to keep his promise.
It's too late to see. No fish. The weather sucks. I'm gonna sit around out here for 3 weeks.
What is that?
Harlequin romance?
Yeah, perfect storm.
That's why it's so damn rotten.
Yeah, I am too.
What happens in this story anyway?
They all die.
Is that true?
They all die.
Brought that on the boat.
Up in the wheelhouse, Linda keeps a firm hand on the controls as the storm lets loose.
When the weather gets so bad that you're afraid the autopilot's not going to be able to keep the bow into the wind, then the captain really has to stand and man the wheel. We're gonna get pounded.
300 miles southeast of Newfoundland, the Eagle Eye 2 is getting pummeled.
50 to 65 knots here. Probably gonna be a pretty bumpy night here tonight.
Although Scotty's main concern is survival.
Seems like it's just been storm after storm. It's like a non-stop roller coaster here.
$40,000 in the hole. He needs to get his gear in the water.
I'm hoping to see it a little calmer by, say, 8 o'clock in the morning.
Scotty tries to get a few hours shut-eye during deckhand Tommy Fox's watch.
Yeah, go home.
Thirty-foot waves there now. Scattering there is 30-footers. Big enough to make a loop, I guarantee you that. That was a big wave that never broke until it got on her stern.
I don't think you guys are gonna stop enough for us to be fishing in. It keeps coming and coming.
Thirty miles to the southwest is the Bjorn 2. After two nights of relentless storm.
We're gonna get pounded.
the weather finally clears.
It took a little bit of toll, you know. Missing a deck tile, a bait table a little smashed up.
That was a hell of a storm. Because completely we broke the table, we didn't even fishing yet.
Linda and her crew survived, but the storm may have drawn the curtain on the Grand Banks season.
Finally, just about daylight this morning, it dropped out enough to knock the boat out of gear, and it's not really good enough to go steaming around looking for water. It's not really what I'd call fishable at the moment. Oh, nice one. Wow. Bobbing around here. Oh, it's getting old. Eagle Eye 2, Bjorn 2. Here, Scotty, come in.
Come on.
We've still got, I don't know, I guess 30. Still got 30 knots here out of the northwest door.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's not flat time. Come on.
The fish have left. You can't catch them if they're not there.
With the fish heading toward shore, instead of throwing in her lines, Linda throws in the towel.
We're heading to Georgia. Are you going to try it, or are you going to come along?
Yeah, I haven't made my mind up yet.
I got to scratch my head about it here. Come on.
Let me know what you decide, or stand by. I know it hurts you guys' feelings to be leaving the Grand Banks. Maybe we'd have better weather on Georgia's anyway.
I could walk home from there.
I've made the decision to get out of here. And I'm optimistic that we'll find some fish on Georgia's, put some fish on the boat. I keep saying we're going to put some fish on the boat. There's still hope.
After a massive storm ripped through the Grand Banks, the troubled Big Eye has run south, where Chomps hopes to change his luck. The Bjorn is holding steady, but is yet to throw any lines on this trip. The Francis Anne has to head to port with only a couple thousand pounds in the hold. The Eagle Eye 2 has caught over 43,000 pounds of fish, but their second trip has so far yielded nothing.
Looking at how much the ocean has changed here today, the water is almost 10 degrees colder than it was.
Now Scotty has to make the crucial decision to hang around or run.
Everybody kind of drove by this spot. They just don't want to stop and try it. I was very tempted to just keep going, but you know, basically I'm a Grand Banks fisherman and we're not leaving until I'm satisfied there's nothing here.
While Scotty goes over his options, the crew clears the deck.
Can you hear me?
I don't know if we're gonna fish here or not.
Nobody knows.
We've been out here about 4 days now. Done anything. Balls are still in the ball cage. We're near ready to fish. Scotty's gotta try to figure out the best move for everyone.
We gotta come up with a course of action.
Yeah, the best move to make us money to keep us safe.
This time of year out here, this far out, 400 mile off, get pretty nasty. Help is a long ways away.
Baits in the baskets, ready to go. Can't even get fishing.
And no fish. Zero. Big, fat, zero, zero.
Up in the wheelhouse, Scotty finds a piece of water that looks promising.
We're hoping we can still find one last hurrah out here.
I know the guys are all sick and tired of riding these storms out for, you know, basically nothing.
I guess it's the last little bit of warm water right here on the Grand Banks. We're gonna try to finish it out right here.
Hopefully the cap made a good decision and we catch some fish.
Fishing's a lot like gambling. You gather information, calculate the odds, and place your bets.
Okay, throw it.
Keeper! Yes, sir, boy, we're fishing on the western side of the Grand Banks there now. It's our first set.
see if there's any big ones left on the Grand Banks.
Yeah, time to fish, time to get that money. You know what I'm saying?
Yep, tomorrow morning, pull our gear back and see if there's any fish going around.
We can catch fish, we might not catch fish, we might catch sharks and fish, we might catch no fish and sharks, we might catch all sharks, might catch all fish, might get our gear cut up in a million pieces with sharks on it. The possibilities are endless.
Over 1,000 miles south off the coast of Georgia is the Big Eye. While the Grand Banks got pounded, Chomps ran south to his home fishing grounds.
We got our ass beat. Instead of dealing with rough weather and cold water, we'll deal with hot water and no wind.
With no fish coming up on deck for over a week, Chomps' crew is eager to fill the hole.
I'm definitely ready to get fishing.
Sure. It's been a while since we've been fishing. Hopefully get out here and hit the right spot. Gonna get it taken care of. Go back home.
Told him to make sure the boat was set up this evening when I went to bed yesterday. Make sure the boat's set up in case I decide to fish.
One thing's for sure, when Chomps' gut tells him to fish, that's when they'll fish.
The ocean's big, it could be full of fish, couldn't be full of nothing. So I'm gonna fish while I can. Catch what I can, try to put something on the boat.
And tonight, he's feeling it.
Finally fish.
Real happy to be sitting out. Hopefully we're sitting in the right spot. Load the boat.
See where the wind's coming straight across, man. Don't want to foul anything up.
Still a man down, Greenhorn Don is forced to work the rail. The dangerous job of tying on Dobbs and setting out the beepers.
Beeper!
Is that buoy in the water?
Oh, no!
It's the longest four Dobbs I've ever seen.
Beeper! Hold up!
On Swords.
Well, Chomber, for better or for worse, I'm gonna run the boat next trip. Business first.
One captain's demoted.
Clean it up.
They're tight.
While another is brought to his knees.
Watch out!
Well, that's gonna break.
And one lives his worst nightmare.
Man overboard!